Man, you're looking good.
Oh, thank you, man. I'm tired. Good to meet you, Chad.
Sit down and have a chat.
Absolutely.
I'm not here to waste your time. We got 5 minutes. Tell you what we're about. We're trying to show that you can have a conversation with anyone about anything.
Yes.
I think argument and debate have their place, but when a one-on-one conversation, it'd be good to know that there's other options rather than just screaming and stuff like that.
That's right. Where are you from?
I'm originally from California.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but I spent time up in Kentucky and I live nearby here now.
Really?
40 minutes south of here.
But you grew up in California?
I grew up all over the place, military.
Oh, you're military. Yeah.
How about you?
Los Angeles.
Look
originally
at you,
from, yeah, but originally from Alabama.
You're originally from Alabama?
Yeah.
All right.
Montgomery.
I went to high school in Macon. So,
oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Amazing.
It's pretty close, but I know
military
it's not.
Military guy,
pretty. Yeah. Yeah. All right. So, why are you here? You want, or let me introduce myself. Ty, we talked to yourself. What's your name?
Jesse Peterson.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Why are you here?
Can we do five to 7 minutes?
Five to 7 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Got a time.
Oh, well, I am participating in the Politicon debate today.
Nice.
And this is the first time that I'm aware that they had it in another state.
Yeah.
And but it's nice to be in Kentucky.
Cool.
I like you here. Oh, in Tennessee.
Yeah,
where
Tennessee.
Are we?
We're in Tennessee.
Tennessee.
I get confused all the time. Trust me. You drive on the highway, they look exactly the same.
And what I do, I have a nonprofit organization called BOND. The Brotherhood Organization of a New Destiny. We've been around for 29 years now.
Nice.
And we are rebuilding a family by rebuilding a man. Also have a radio talk show.
Cool.
JLP Talk.
Please give me your card afterwards. I'd like to get connected with that.
What's your JLPTalk.com and said a TV show, the fallenstate.tv.
Oh, make sure you're in the mic. Are you in, so you said you're doing a debate. What are you debating? Or what's your position?
I am a conservative all the way.
Not a problem with that.
At one time, I was a Democrat. When I was a beta male, I was a Democrat. But God forgave me, and I became a. I asked God to forgive me because real men are conservative and not liberal Democrats.
What I've
only
noticed
beta males are Democrats.
When you don't have, I've heard this. When, as you make more money, Republican, you become way less. You become more concerned with what's being done with your money. Which makes you more conservative.
Well, when you're more independent, you do. You pay attention to your money. You know, you want to invest it well. You want less taxes and all that crap.
Yeah.
But I became a conservative before I got any money at all.
Talk to me then.
Once I became a Christian, I looked at the platforms. Because at the time, I was a Democrat, right? So I looked at the platform of the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. And I realized that the Democratic Party itself is evil.
Mm.
And the people who represent the Democratic Party are evil people.
Do
they
you value
support
faith?
Abortion. They support homosexuality.
Yeah.
They're anti-military. They're anti-God. And so I could no longer identify with that.
Is
and so
faith,
I looked at the Republican.
Is faith a big part of like how you make decisions? And what is how do you define it?
That's the only way I make decisions.
Ooh. How do you define faith? What's it mean to you?
Loving God with all your heart, soul, and might, along with nothing else. And we love him, you can't help but have faith in him. But most people don't have faith in God. Even though they say they do, they don't. And you can tell by their lifestyle.
So it's possible to say you have faith in God, but actually not
Absolutely.
Have...
Most Christians don't have it. They know the Bible, they know about God, but they don't know him.
How do you tell the difference between someone who has real faith and someone who has fake faith then?
The way they live, the love, they have perfect love for all people because in them, God's love, right?
Yeah.
And so they love all people. They don't accept good, evil as good, and they don't worry about what others think about them.
Can we only figure that out by just looking at them? And can someone fake it?
No.
It's impossible to fake it.
It's impossible to fake it.
It's impossible to fake it.
Matter of fact, it's impossible to be a son or a daughter of God and still sin. And so anyone that's telling you that they sin, they are not of God. Satan is their daddy.
Sins or daddy.
Yeah. All in the name of Jesus.
Okay.
Because you cannot sin if you believe in God.
What else is really good along with faith? Along with faith. What other systems are also good?
The order of God.
To come up with decisions on like how politics should be made or like how to spend your money.
Oh,
like
I see. Well, when you believe in God, you can't help but do the right thing because he's guiding you. His love,
what would he
his
guide
life.
You to?
Everything he does is perfect.
Yeah, but like
he would guide you.
What's like if I had to make a list of things that I need to like make good decisions in life? Faith number one. What's number two? What's number three?
Everything. The whole aspect of your life. Where you go, what you do, how you carry yourself, how you invest your money. He would give you, if you want a wife, he would give you the right woman to marry.
Mm. And so it's like faith or nothing else.
Right.
You and either faith
believe
is loving
or
God.
You don't believe.
What happens if you don't believe?
Then you suffer.
Oh.
Life is hell on earth.
Like what?
You have fear, you have doubt, you have anger, you have worry, you have anxiety, you're not sure what to do in life, you can't see the right way to go. Anyone who has anger is of Satan.
Okay.
Because anger is of their father, the devil. There is no anger in God.
So it's impossible to be angry and have faith at the same time?
It's impossible to be angry and love God. If you have anger, you're not of God.
Man, in realistically, as I'm thinking about that, that means like very, very, very few people would love God. Because
right.
Anger seems to be a natural human
right.
thing.
That's why he said you must be born again. And the way you're born again, you got to overcome your mama and return to your father. If you don't love your earthly father, it's impossible to love God. It's impossible to know him. Because what the mother has done, she's turned the children away from the father toward her. And Satan is her daddy. And so you become like what you're angry, who you hate, right? You become just like them. And that's why you see a lot of men who act like women. Any man that has anger is a woman.
Is there any person that disagrees with you on this?
A whole lot.
Tell me something that they said that you're like, I see what you're saying. I hear what you're coming from,
you
but still
women,
what?
You hate women, you hate whatever, you hate black, you hate this and that, but I don't care. I know that you must be born again, and you got to overcome the mother. That's why God said, one day he's going to return the children to the fathers and the fathers to the children.
Hear me out. For the people that disagree with you, I know what you would say to them, but like, what's something that they said to you?
They call me Uncle Tom, sellout. You hate blacks, you hate yourself, you hate your mom, you hate your daddy. All kind of stuff.
Can I just ask one last question? Because I think we're running out of time.
Absolutely.
Cool. If it turned out that, and I'm not saying it's the case, but if the Republican Party ever went away from, you know, faith, as we've talked about it today, would that make you say, okay, Republicans don't get it either?
Well, I'm already saying that because most Republicans do not believe in God.
Oh, you're already at the point. So you're more like, and help me out, you're more like, I have this position, I have this criteria of whether or not you're with God or you're not with God. And if you're Republican and you match it, or conservative and you match it, great.
Well,
but if you don't, you're out.
Well, you don't have to be a Christian to be a conservative. Conservative is just a political thing.
Okay, you have to
and
be a Christian.
And if you notice that a lot of conservatives are starting to accept so-called same-sex marriage, they accept an abortion, they don't deal with the social issues. It's more political now.
I get it.
But when I first became a conservative, it was about God and conservatism, right?
It but conformed with your religious beliefs.
Yeah.
And they're already not doing that, so...
A lot of them are not.
Would you then say, hey, I'm more of a Christian first, a conservative second?
Absolutely. Right.
Okay.
My values come from God, but I vote for conservative if they are, you know.
Because
people like the Great
right
White
now.
Hope. You know who the Great White Hope
the
is?
I know the boxer and like whenever it's a white guy championing something.
We have a new Great White Hope.
Talk to me.
Donald Trump.
Okay, yeah.
The Great White Hope.
Orange? A little tan. Help me out.
But I want you to know that any man who has anger is a woman.
Okay.
That's why when they get with women... Women are their gods, right? And so they control the men. The men become the boy, and she become the mama.
Can an angry man and a man have a baby?
An angry man?
Yeah.
And a man? What do you mean?
Like an angry man's a woman, right?
He's a woman in nature, yeah.
Oh, so can an angry man and a woman have a baby together?
Can they have a baby?
Yeah, like can they have birth? Can
they get
birth?
An angry man and a woman.
An angry man and a man.
Oh, no. In spirit, they're just like a woman, but not in the physical.
Okay. Is there a women that are not angry?
There might be. It's right. Hard to find them, but I'm sure they're out there somewhere.
I think you keep
Have
working
you
hard.
Ever met a woman with no anger?
I don't think I met anybody with no anger.
I know. Isn't that unfortunate? And yet they say they believe in God.
I mean, just saying, being honest, like even I'm angry sometimes.
You're angry? You
even
have
I'm
anger?
I'm angry sometimes.
You need to overcome
Have
your
it?
Mama.
Overcome what?
Your mother.
Oh, Obama?
Your mother.
Oh, I thought you said Obama for
no,
a second.
No, your mama. He's a beta male. Obama is a beta male. I call Obama the fallen messiah, and Michelle Obama Big Mama Michelle.
So if you are dealing with anger, basically you're saying...
It's a spirit. You have to overcome it.
You have to have like a mental fortitude.
You need to go and forgive your mother for turning you away from your father. She couldn't help it.
Everyone has to do that first before they can come to any sort of political
conclusion? No, before they can become children of God.
Okay. Ah, this is just become a Christian then.
Yes. Yeah.
So you have to believe in God before you're a Christian, basically, is what you're saying.
You have to go and forgive your mother.
Yeah, you're basically saying you have to become a Christian.
Are you going to forgive your mother?
I'll work on it. How about that?
No, you had to go and do it. You can't
work on it.
Okay. Because otherwise, you're going to be controlled by women. They will always be your God.
I'll tell you this right now. It's like, in order to become a Christian, you have to believe in Christianity. Is that?
No, you have to forgive your mother and return to your father.
So there's a process to
you must be
a
born again.
Yeah, you have to be reborn again. Okay. Yeah. I mean,
are you going to forgive your mother?
Why not?
Are you?
Why not?
You going to go to her and tell her I forgive you for what you did to me?
Why not?
Are you?
Well, she's deaf.
She's deaf?
She's deaf, but I can sign
up. Yeah, you can. Just...
Hey, that's very offensive. I'm just playing with you.
Oh, okay.
Okay, cool.
Man, it was good talking to you, all right?
Yeah? Yeah? You got a card?
Yeah.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
It's amazing. Oh. What do you call it?
Street epistemology.
Oh. Street epistemology. Amazing.
Nice. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you, man.
Appreciate it.
Cool. Are you the bodyguard?
Or? No.
That's my PR guy. That's nice. Hermias.
Very cool. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, did you like that?
Yeah, that was fun. Yeah. I appreciate talking to you.
Go forgive your mother, man.
Yeah.
You too.
It's a nonprofit card.
So you can overcome.
Got another one for you. Thanks, man.
Woman in the right. Right on. Right on. Thank you, man.
Have a good one. Wasn't that bad? No? Like, I think the impression was like, you have to be a Christian to be a Christian. And I was like, oh, well then that's not even political. And I kind of agree with that. So, yeah, like, you kind of have to hold some misogynist points of view. So I was like, you probably do. Like, so here's my thing. Like, here's my argument. When someone is accurately reflecting what the religion represents,
yeah,
I don't have an issue with that. I have a problem when I have a problem when someone says, no, God really does love everybody, every single person equally, and there's no hell. I'm like, you're not talking about what's in your holy book. This guy's like, if you're angry, you're a woman. Women are low tier. Men are the best.
He has a valid argument. It's just the soundness there.
It is consistent with his holy book.
He has a consistent.
And I'm like, you are accurately reflecting what your beliefs are, and if your position is you have to be a Christian to be a Christian. I agree. And if you have to believe those things be what the book tells you to be,
yeah,
I'm fine with that. Politically, I don't think I asked him before, I was like, you have to be a Christian first, religious second.
And yeah, it's Christianity at the top of the hierarchy there.
And then I'm like, oh, okay, well then it's just really only faith. Faith only, and that's it. I'm like, we're not really talking about like how it implies to society. It's just your appreciation. What'd you guys think about that? 5-minute plug or debate?
What'd you guys think?
White Opponent just talks about God most of the time. You should listen to the rest of our chats. We've been doing it. Angry woman helping God's rep.
yeah.
Like, I would say there's definitely, you don't have to necessarily be down on women to be a Christian, but the holy textbook of Christianity is not good on women. And if I was to meet someone who was only informed by that book, I'd probably be talking to a guy like Jesse, and I'd be like, thank you for being an accurate representation of what you believe.
And he talked about the Great White Hope.
Yeah. So that changes over time to like whoever. Did you know about that?
No.
So there was a point where there was only white boxers, right? And then one super awesome heavyweight boxer came in who was black, who just crushed everybody. And so the Great White Hope as a moniker came about when there was like this one Italian guy who was like, I might be good enough to beat this one black guy. He wasn't. He got smashed too. But since then, we've like moved the trend to other sports where it's like...
Okay, and now it's into politics.
And now it's in politics.
Again. Interesting.
Only after like the black guy's been in charge for like for a short period of time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sweet.
Yo.